Okay, that was not fun at all, believe me. Yeah, that could have been a lot better, but I missed almost. I call that a win. Okay, let's let my character speak first, because he clearly earned this victory for us. I could have done that a lot better. I didn't dodge all the hits I could have dodged, but hey, hey. The butcher is no more, and I'm happy for that, because he was a pain in the whatever, unclean heart. Craft a powerful toxin. Also, we got some traits, I think. Glutton. If you use a consumable, you get more speed. Huh. Well, I guess that could be useful, but then again... Yeah, let's break all these spots. Now, let's collect our remaining loot and let's get out of here. Yeah, this is only vengeance. Oh, you can even go down here? What's down here? Well, it appears this is the money area. Yeah, now we can destroy his whole house. Oh well, I guess this is the bonus stage. So yeah, don't forget to check this area out if you beat him. Ooh, that was actually a nice amount of scrap. Ah, that won't stay hidden from me. Oh, and he had a little generator in his basement. That's so cute. Yeah, this is what I call trick shooting. Sorry about delaying the video. But I just want to destroy everything he owns, because he was a very angry boss. To be honest, he was not so hard, but you just need a better tactic to fight him. As you can see, he took so much damage from headshots, and of course the little monsters helped a lot. Also, fire bullets seemed to do the trick against him, and I only used 3 dragon shards. So yeah, that was a good win, right? Not really. Hey, what about this? You mean I can't get my money? Well, that's bad. Can I bore myself because I can't get my money? No, I can't. He had a little operation going from himself. Did you see that? Is that? Anyway, let's just get out of here because I'm sick of this guy. I think this was the 10th attempt or something like that. Anyway, it probably works with most builds, so it's not so hard. You just have to dodge his hammers and watch out for the pots he smashes, because sometimes there'll be monsters inside. Other than that, I don't know what I can tell you more. Just be careful in the last phase, you don't get hit by the hammer, and always try to watch him, because if you don't watch him, he may throw your hammer at you or he may jump at you, but if you let him destroy the whole house and then there are no walls, you can be pretty much assured you'll win the game. Okay, let's not do that, because that will only make it harder for us to leave the area. How many minutes was that? 5 or 6, I think. Yeah. One time I even managed to beat him a lot faster than that, but sadly, in the end I got tangled by some monsters, so that's why I kept killing all the monsters I could. I know he can kill them as well, but to be honest, the corners are the problem. If you get cornered by a monster in the corner or by the boss, it's game over. Yeah, that was a hard one. I didn't see how much scrap he gave me, but I think it was a lot. So what was it called? The unclean heart. The Vix worm toxin, what?
Alright then.
A devastator, so this is like a crossbow, I think. So fires a large pack that deals 1 to 125 damage. Oh, that's not so bad, I think. How much? 650. We're done here. So how good is the Devastator then? Oh, it fires so slow. Nonetheless, I think this is a pretty good attribute. So let's see, 125 damage, stagger damage and bleeding effect. So that's 10 damage per second, that should be 275 plus the damage, so that's about 300 damage per special hit. Oh, this will be interesting. And it looks like it's a big bolt, it does some kind of area of effect damage too. Let's test it on the armor. Yeah, it's amazing. Step into the light, let's see the weapon better. Looks like a fully metal crossbow or something. It's hard to describe what I'm seeing. Yeah, let's go near the fireplace. I mean, it's kind of cool, but... Anyway, see you next time. Bye!